2019 has been a tremendous year.
Yes, it has been a tremendous year. I'm just thinking back about the beginning of the year where just kind of put forth that vision statement to just lay out who we are as a church. And we talked about being a Jesus church, being a kingdom-minded church, being a Great Commission church. You know, as a Jesus church, we're a church that's about God's word, because Jesus, of course, is the living word of God.
Preach what? Preach the gospel. Evangelism, or evangelical. You can see the connection there. And it's the word that means good news.
So we're committed to the scripture, we're committed to teaching and preaching. And then as a Jesus church, we're a church where we want to have an atmosphere of love, because God is love.
I was saved at age 13, but the Lord led me to Calvary Chapel by the encouragement of my Sunday school teacher. And I came in the early 70s and have loved being in this Jesus church ever since.
One thing that I appreciate among many things, the church is, as has been expressed by Brian, how the Word of God is taught so faithfully here. Something that Pastor Brian has done for me in the past few years that's very helpful is helping me to think about how to live out the word in the culture today.
We are part of the Limitless Sunday School class here on Sunday mornings, which help families who have children with disabilities.
I think this is one of the ways we are a Jesus church in trying to reach out to all kinds of situations, and in this case, allowing our families to come here and also learn the Word of God.
But Brian, I also like that we're a kingdom-minded church.
Yep, I like that too.
Because that means that we're part of a worldwide global movement of those who love Jesus and are committed to seeing the kingdom of God built on earth.
Yeah, and it's such a great thing to be able to partner with the people of God. And, you know, one of the biggest places where we partner with folks is at Creation Fest.
Absolutely.
In the UK.
But part of it is also the Unbelievable Conference that came here.
Yeah.
Having John Lennox.
Yeah.
Having
Justin Briley.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Mary Jo Sharp.
Yeah.
And some of these great apologists in the faith come and share here at the church. I mean, it was explosive.
Yeah.
It was so, I loved that day.
Yeah.
To me, being kingdom-minded is about embracing the reality that the people of God, the church, is bigger than any individual, any particular local church, any evangelical denomination or movement. One of the most important reasons for us to be kingdom-minded at Calvary Chapel Costa Mesa has to do really with what I think of as our mission effectiveness. In John chapter 17, Jesus prayed that all of his followers throughout the history of the church age would be one in him. And he said the reason that that was important is so that the world would believe that the Father had sent him as the Redeemer. And so there's a connection with our spirit of unity as Christians between ourselves and other followers of God from other Christian denominations, other countries, other ethnicities, and our mission effectiveness, our evangelistic effectiveness. So I think that the connection between our unity and our effectiveness in God's mission is probably one of the greatest reasons that having an attitude of kingdom-mindedness is important.
And then, of course, a Great Commission church.
Absolutely.
So the Great Commission is getting the gospel out to everybody. So everyone in all the world can hear the gospel. We have ministry literally all around the world. And we thank God for that, that he's given us the wonderful facilities. We have facilities in Europe. We have facilities in South America. We have facilities in the UK. And through all of those facilities, we are doing a Great Commission work.
Great Commission has a innermost core. We can call this as a gospel, and it has multiple layers of love. We need to have love with someone to share the Great Commission, the gospel.
I see Calvary Chapel Costa Mesa being a Great Commission church through its many outreach programs. From Christmas to Easter, they have been so outgoing, and I'm involved in numerous different programs such as the Soul Love Ministry and involving so many different cultures. And for my 10 years of being in Calvary Chapel Costa Mesa, I've seen that their work is all the way around the globe and it's reaching every single different type of person.
This summer I've been involved in the trip to Creation Fest as I was involved at the youth tent and just got to talk with lots of kids and just teaching them about the love of Christ and just playing sports and playing video games and just hanging out with them and having a good time.
One of our unchurched friends invited us for the New Year's party. And we said we would love to go, but we wanted to go, at the same time, we wanted to go to the church. So we went with some promise cards, the word of the God. We were able to share what the promise meant to them.
But you know, I love just the fact that it's 2020 coming up.
Yeah.
And I think about 2020 and how that has to do with vision.
Yep.
And I just feel that as much as the Lord has done, there is so much more that He wants to do, especially as the time of His return is drawing closer and closer.
Yeah.
I believe He wants to pour out His Spirit in even a greater measure.
Yeah. Yeah, and we've got vision for 2020. We've been thinking about it, praying about it, looking forward to it, but we're not gonna tell anybody about it right now. We're gonna wait till January of 2020.
Sounds good.
We're gonna share the fresh vision for the year.
That's gonna be awesome.
Right?
Absolutely, and you'll tell me what that vision is, right?
I will, I'll clue you in.
Okay, then I'm ready.
All right.
Anytime.